I was 38 years old, still young. My kids were in second and fourth grade, and I was in pretty good shape. My dad was in the hospital quite a bit, and I can remember distinctly walking up the stairs in the hospital, and I couldn't breathe getting up the stairs. So at that point is when I went into the doctor. He said, let's just order a CAT scan to be safe.
I was in a cotton field, and I get a call from Shannon. They've just found something in my heart, and they won't let me leave. They won't even let me stand up. And I think I'm going to have to go into surgery pretty quickly.
He said, you have a myxoma, a mass in your heart. It's about the size of an egg. We need to take you straight to the hospital.
When you're in the hospital and you're waiting on someone that you love, things on the periphery kind of fade away. And you look people in the eye and they're looking at you for real.
I really got to see God truthfully. I had prayed for His presence to be with me, and He showed me through all the people that came to visit. For a heart surgery, it was as fast and easy as it could have been. I kept telling the kids, in a month, I'm going to climb Pinnacle Mountain. And that's my goal, in 1 month. And I did. 1 month from the day, we very, very slowly climbed up Pinnacle Mountain. And it was great. It was really great. It was about 5 years later. I picked my daughter up after school from basketball practice. She got in the car. Mom, my heart feels, something's not right. My heart feels funny. It's not something any mother wants to hear.
What the problem was SVT, and it could possibly be treated with a heart ablation.
About 3 days before her procedure was to be done, my heart did this little jump. I was like, what are the chances I have the same thing as my daughter? And they told me I had AFib. I said, just put me on some medicine because I've got my daughter's thing coming up, and that was forefront on my mind. So in the hospital, we were waiting on her. I just wanted to kind of pray and contemplate, because you just worry when your daughter's in there. The doctor came out and said, she did all right. We got these fixed. He let me go back and see her. He said, but let's go ahead and get you in, shock your heart back into place, because my heart's AFibbing this whole time.
There I am with two heart patients in two different rooms, and I'm going back and forth between the two patients. And so it's a wonder I didn't have a heart attack.
The interesting part was Merritt had to take both my daughter and I home from the hospital with our little hospital bracelets on, and we were both good when we left. Both of us had Merritt running around, and my son, Hayden, who was great. He was such a support. I was getting to the point where my AFib was coming more often.
And the research continued to get better and better. All of a sudden, eventually, it opened up that the odds are now pretty good that we can cure your AFib with an ablation.
There was about a 70% chance of it working, and it worked. Now I'm able to do the things that I wasn't able to do for the 5, 6, 7 years that I had AFib. Started talking about doing a triathlon, and I said, I want to do one. She said, Mom, I'm going to do that triathlon with you. So that was really great.
It's fantastic to be able to see them go through that and come out on the other side. Within the past week, she's kayaked, swam over a mile, biked 14, 15 miles, and she ran up and down Pinnacle Mountain several times. That's just within the past 7 days.
We all need to support the American Heart Association, because 1 in 3 women die of heart disease.
The research is always continuing, but it requires funding. It always requires funding. These are expensive studies that they're doing.
I wouldn't be here today if there wasn't the research and the doctors and the knowledge that there is. There's just too many lives at stake. And hopefully, not just save their life, but bring back the quality of life that they can enjoy a long and happy life. It all comes around. My dad was in the hospital for something completely different, for cancer, but I told him before he passed away, if you hadn't have been in the hospital and I hadn't been there to visit you, I would have been scared of hospitals. Something came out of his experience to help me. And I was prepared for what I was going to go through by seeing what he went through. And then I feel the same way about Savannah. Hopefully there's a purpose for what you're going through. There was too much to learn from it. There was too much faith that came out of it, friendships that grew from it. And priorities that you learned from it. I wouldn't change it for anything.